Welcome back to the continuation of the discussion for user-defined function. This time, we will be solving the same problem for the solution with return type and with passing parameters. Now, before I continue, I am showing you different solution for inputting two numbers and outputting the highest number using the different function declaration. Now, if you will be the one solving it, again, similar with the looping statement, you will be the one to choose whether to use the first function declaration, the without return type and without passing parameter if you want, or you can use also function without return type and with passing parameter, or you can use with return type and without passing parameter. I am just showing you here the versatility of different function. The important thing that you should understand is the placement of the input, process, and output, whether to place it inside the main or place it inside the user-defined function. As you can see, I have the same problem, but I can solve it using the different function declaration. Same thing that you should do with the remaining exercise in the laboratory. You can apply any of the function declaration that we have covered, and then you can just choose from any solution that we have discussed. So let us continue. For function declaration number 4, for the without return type and with passing parameter, it says that in this type of function declaration, input is in main, process is in the user-defined function, and output is in main. Input and output is in main, process is in the user-defined function. So let's go back to the C++ code that we have. So for the fourth declaration, we have int highest. This time I can use again highest num because this is the original function, and then I will be overloading it with the function with parameter now. So this one is valid. As you can see, it doesn't have any red lines on it. And then, it says that in case 3, input and output is in main. So I'll just copy this. This is the input from case 2. I will just copy this going to case 4. So input. Indention. And then, aside from input, you also have the output, which we already did for case 3. So I'm just copying it. After the input, you have the process here. And then let me just put here, this is the function call. Same thing here. This is the function call. Okay. So I'm done with the input and output, which is placed in main. So this is our input and output. So the remaining thing that I need to do is the process. So I just copy the process from this one. So I'll just copy this and do some editing. So it has now parameters N1N. N2. So input, remove it from here. We've already done it in the main function. So process will stay here. So this one is okay now. So let us check. Again, if you will be the one solving it, it's not a requirement that you will use the four different function declaration. You just need to choose from among the function declaration which you think is the easiest for you. I'm just giving you an option and showing you how to use each different function declaration. So let us check function declaration number 4. So we will go to main first and simulate case number 4. So this is case number 4. When I press 4, so this is the first statement that it will execute under case 4. It says input first number. Again, I will input the same number, 67. For the second number, I will input again 67. So after entering the two numbers, the variable equal val is assigned a value of false. And then we will call the function. Now there will be an error here. Sorry, I forgot. So let's stop the execution. In case 4, the function now has parameter. So we should put here n1n, n2. Okay, I forgot that. So it should call highest n1 and n2. Without putting there n1 and n2, what will happen is that it will call function declaration number 3 instead of number 4. So let's run it again. So again, case 4, first statement will be input the first number, 67, input the second number, 67. So what happened is that equal val is assigned a value of false, and then you call the function passing the value that we've entered for n1 and n2. So the value that we've entered for n1 and n2 are both 67. So when we go to function declaration number 4, this value here will get the value 67, as well as n2 will get the value of 67. So checking the condition, is 67 greater than 67? No. Therefore, it will go to the next one. Is 67 greater than 67? No again. Therefore, it will go to else, wherein the value of the variable equal val is assigned to true. And then return high. So what is the value of high, even if we haven't used it? So the value of high that will be returned is by the default value, which is 0. But we don't need to do anything with high because the value that was satisfied here is equal val is equal to true. So when we go back to main, so here we have the condition if true, so the value of equal val is true. If true, it will display the two numbers are equal. That's why we have here the statement the two numbers are equal. Okay? So let us simulate it one more time. This time, I will enter two different value, 12 and 25. So, value of n1 is 12, value of n2 is 25, and then equal val is assigned false, and then pass the value of 12 and 25 to function declaration number 4. This one, is 12 greater than 25? No. So, it will go to the next one. Is 25 greater than 12? The answer is yes. Therefore, 25 now is the new value of the variable high, which will be returned to the calling function. So when we go back to main, this statement now, which is equal now to 25, so from this function call, the value that was returned by the function is 25. This 25 now will become the new value of the variable high. Okay? And then equal val will stay with false because the last condition in our function declaration number 4 was not satisfied. So if false, therefore it will not execute the C out in the if condition. Instead, it will go to else and it will display the highest number entered is high. So what is the value of high right now? The value is 25. So let's check. The highest number entered is 25. Okay? So let us check now the flowchart for function declaration number 4 with return type and with passing parameter. So this is the function flowchart for function declaration number 4 with return type and with passing parameter.